Avionics, this is flight on mission code.
Flight avionics.
Please confirm all AV bats have been switched to internal power.
Confirm vehicles on internal power.
RCO, flight on mission code.
This RCO, go ahead.
Confirm ground power has been disabled on all three stages.
All stage power is down.
And to all operators, vehicle is on internal power.
Pressing locks.
PLS, flight on mission code.
Go ahead.
Please disable anti-geysering and confirm.
Pressing Kiro.
Confirmed, disabled.
Stage 1, confirm stage 1 is pressed.
Stage 1 pressed.
Stage 2, confirm stage 2 is pressed.
Stage 2 is pressed.
AV battery checks.
High flow engine purge active.
Commanding deluge on.
Kelly John.
Readying GNC systems. Re-readying engines.
Ten, nine, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
First motion.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
As you just saw, we've had successful liftoff of Rocket Lab's STP-27RD mission on That's a Funny Looking Cactus. The next major milestone we're coming up to is Max-Q, or maximum aerodynamic pressure.
Guidance is normal.
This is where the forces on the vehicle are at their greatest during flight. So let's listen in.
Coming up on max Q. Max Q.
And there you have it. Electron has passed through max Q, or maximum aerodynamic pressure.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
Coming up soon, Electron will go through a series of key mission milestones in relatively quick succession. Starting with main engine cutoff, or MECO, the 9 Rutherford engines on Electron's first stage will shut down in preparation for stage 2 separation. Following this separation, we'll see ignition of the vacuum-optimized Rutherford engine on Electron's second stage.
Speed is 2 kilometers per second.
Entering burnout detect mode.
Five seconds remaining.
Stage 1 MECO.
Stage separation succeeded.
Stage 2 engine started.
As you can see, we have had MECO, or main engine cutoff. Electron's first and second stages have separated from each other, and the vacuum-optimized Rutherford engine on Electron's second stage will continue onto orbit. Very soon, we will see the fairing jettison and fall away from the vehicle. The fairing protects the payloads during ascent, but it isn't needed once we ascend to the thinner parts of the atmosphere.
Fairing separate.
And there it goes. Electron's fairing has been jettisoned to make way for payload deployment approximately 50 minutes from now. With the fairing gone, Electron continues towards orbit. Everything is looking great so far.
Guidance remains nominal.
This is Mission Control Auckland. Electron's performing as expected, and we're continuing on a nominal trajectory. Go, Electron!
Stage 2 propulsion is nominal.
If you're just joining us, we've had successful launch of the STP-27RD mission aboard Electron. We've had stage separation, and Electron is continuing onto orbit. Mission Control Auckland checking in with you live during Electron's launch of the STP-27RD mission. As you can see, Stage 2 is continuing on its journey to orbit. Our next major milestone will be the battery hot swap. If you've watched our previous launches, you'll be familiar with this process, but if you're just joining us for the first time, here's what happens. Electron's Rutherford engines use electric pumps powered by lithium polymer batteries, but once these batteries are depleted, they're just dead weight. To overcome this, we perform a hot swap, where we switch over power from the depleted batteries to a fully charged one, providing a more efficient ride to orbit. So look out for the battery jettison shortly.
Vehicles to the safe gate.
AFTS is safe.
HV battery hot swap. HV battery eject.
Stage 2 propulsion nominal.
As you can see, we've had successful hot swap and jettison of the depleted batteries. Stage 2 propulsion is nominal, and our trajectory is looking good.
Seconds remaining. Speed is 5.5 kilometers per second. Altitude is 198 kilometers.
Just a bit of a recap for the launch of the STP-27RD mission on Electron. We've had successful ignition, stage one burn, and stage separation, and we're now following stage two as it continues onto orbit, transporting three satellites
during
for the space
stage
test program.
Detect mode.
This burn will continue until around T plus 9 minutes, and then our kick stage will separate.
Stage two
So we've got about 1 minute left before stage two engine shutdown.
Seconds remaining.
Engine shut down.
Transfer orbit looks good.
Engine shut down. Confirm stage three separation.
And with that call, we can confirm that the kick stage has separated from Electron's second stage. As we mentioned earlier, we won't be receiving video of today's payload deployment, so we've prepared a short video illustrating this process. At approximately T plus 54 minutes, the three satellites on today's mission will be deployed to precise, predefined orbits in quick succession. So stay tuned to our social media channels for confirmation of this payload deployment. So with that, we're going to end today's webcast. A huge thanks to the U.S. Air Force, their space test program, and our mission partners for choosing to launch on Electron. Thank you also to the FAA and the New Zealand Space Agency for licensing this launch.